one God.
Coming in the clouds with great power.
have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But as for the day or hour, nobody knows it, neither the angels of heaven nor the Son. No one but the Father. My brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord. So there are times when we become very anxious about the frequency of natural calamities with so many casualties. There are also sustained terrorist activities in some parts of the world, and perhaps unexpected. They too is fearless. All of a sudden, give us a 360 vertex or view. And sometimes too, because our media providers inundate us with so much scary things, we are made to believe that the world is a terrible place to stay. And we see too good that the end time is just around the corner. But I am not trying to be complacent. Nor I am saying, go on with your life. Just ignore all these prophecies. That is not my point. My point is, we can actually do a lot of things to improve our lives and to prepare ourselves when this time arrives. Characteristic of the Sunday before Christ the Sunday is its apocalyptic readings. The first reading in the Gospel speak about the end times, the judgment day. Meaning, the theme of the Sunday is all about the end of the world, or the final judgment. For some, the readings are a bit scary and can cause anxiety too. But what is the point of the church for arranging it is simply to remind us of the day of reckoning. It can be understood as an individual accounting before the Lord when death comes to us, or it may be understood in the final judgment as the final judgment for all creation as prophesied in the Bible. But the truth is, both will come with certainty. So, but the wisdom of the liturgy is to tell us again and again that our purpose is to win the battle against evil. That is very key, to possess happiness, because it is our best option. To enjoy peace and tranquility with God as our final end. I think we have to be very conscious about all these things in life. And what the church reminds us through the liturgy, because many times we settle for the less or the apparent good, and we put all our efforts on them, later realizing that our efforts must go to something more rewarding or more important. But our time is running out, and we end up desperate and distraught. Who among you were watching or watched the TV program Bad Habits and Holy Orders? Bad Habits and Holy Orders. Have you seen that? Anybody yet? Very few. How people live with me? But I thought that some of you have watched this program. It's very, very encouraging, very interesting. Okay? transformation on these 5 days, starting from appreciating their own giftedness and self-worth, appreciation of vegan happiness, and joy against desires and pressures, self-respect and the worth of the other persons, or respect for others, and finally, discovering their purpose in life, or at least looking at that direction. And you will understand the whole program. And you will appreciate the whole program. Because it is a very, very active thing, especially for our young people. When people say that I'm not here on this earth just to enjoy life, but I have a purpose, and I can enjoy my life with a purpose clear to me. And that is precisely the meaning of this program. So I thought at the beginning when I was looking at the previews, I thought, oh, this is rubbish. But when I was looking at it, when I watching it, it is very, very helpful for the young people, for the young in the world today. Giving opportunities to young people to see things in a different perspective. And that is the perspective of direction, love, appreciation of oneself, appreciation of others, and appreciation of the purpose why God made us here. So in some way, our readings are giving us the same opportunity as this verse to reevaluate our priorities and see for ourselves where do I put most of my resources, where do I focus my efforts. I tell you, if you wish to be a good rugby player or a netball player, you put efforts in building your muscles, your speed and agility, plus of course a good mental grasp of the game. That is why probably you understand very few people here, some are watching rugby, all odds against them are skinny. But the young people will do that. They prepare, I want to be a good player, I want to be a good doctor, I want to be a good writer. Then we prepare for all these things. So, you don't focus on alcohol or drugs because you have something to achieve for your life. So this Sunday, let us also focus on The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, we Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered far by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself. That the people form as one by the unity of the Trinity, may the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so in company with the Christ of angels, we praise you with the joy we proclaim. His wondrous resurrection and ascension. passing from this life. Give God that we can stay in kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow all the world, all that is good. Through him, Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly going forward that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us close in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just as our reminders tonight of Ovi and St. Thomas's at 6:30 and the ticket is $10. It's also the spending of the Basilica. And also after the Mass, there'll be people selling tickets for apples and cakes outside the church. And don't forget to pray for your priests to start coming here tonight. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Master said, go in peace, glorify your name.